students, today our topic is about the measurement of dielectric characteristics of the insulating material. Now dielectric characteristics are insulation resistance, absorption induction index, polarization index and dielectric discharge current. Let us give a brief introduction about the electrical insulation testing. All electrical installation and electrical equipment completely depends on insulation resistance so that they can operate safely. Whether it involves connecting cables, sectioning and protection equipment, or the motors or generators, electrical conductors are insulated using these materials which is of high resistivity in order to limit the leakage current flowing outside the conductor. The quality of these insulating material changes over time due to the stresses affecting the equipment. The stresses may be an electrical stress or temperature stress, etc. Thus, these stresses will reduce the electrical resistivity, thereby it will increase the leakage current, and this will lead to the serious in terms of safety for both operating people and the property, and the cost of protection stoppages. Electrical, in addition to the measurement carried out on new and reconditioned equipment during commissioning, regular insulation testing on installation equipment helps to avoid such incidents through preventive maintenance. These tests detect aging and premature deterioration of the insulating material before they reach a level likely to cause the incidents described above. Dielectric testing and insulation resistance measurement, these two terms are often used. We should have the clarity in these two words. At this stage, it is good idea to clarify the difference between the two type of measurement, which is often get confused. Dielectric testing means, it is also known as breakdown testing. It measures the insulation ability to withstand the medium duration voltage surge without stopover occurring. In reality, the voltage surge may be due to the lightning or switching over voltages or due to some other faults. The main purpose of this test is to ensure the construction rules concerning leakage path and clearance that has to be followed during the installation. This test is often performed by applying an AC voltage. In certain cases, DC voltage is also applied. This type of measurement requires high pot tester. The result obtained is a voltage value usually expressed in kilovolts. Dielectric testing is a destructive nature. In the event of a fault, depending on the tester levels and available energy in the instrument. For this reason, it is reserved for type test or on new or reconditioned equipments. Type test means a certain sample is taken from a lot and it is all the samples need not be tested. Insulation resistance means, the insulation resistance means, however, it is a non-destructive test and a normal test condition. Here, DC voltage is applied, which is relatively low in magnitude. It yields a result in kilo-ohms, mega-ohms, giga-ohms and tera-ohms. The resistance indicates the quality of the insulation between two conductors. Because it is non-destructive, it is particularly useful for monitoring insulation aging during the operating life of electrical equipment or installation. The measurement is performed using an insulation tester, also called megohmmeter. In other words, it is called as megger. Insulation and the causes of insulation failure. Before measuring insulation using megger, a part of the preventive maintenance policy, it is important to understand the different possible causes of insulation performance deterioration so that steps can be taken to reduce this degradation. It is possible to divide these causes into 5 groups. While keeping in mind, if no corrective measures are implemented, these different causes will get superimposed, leading to insulation breakdown and equipment failure. What are the 5 causes? They are electrical stresses, mechanical stresses, chemical stresses, stresses linked with temperature variation, stresses due to environmental contamination. Electrical stress means it is mainly due to over voltage and under voltage. Mechanical stresses means frequently starting and shutdown sequences will create mechanical stresses. also balancing problems on rotating machinery and any direct stress to the cables during installation will give mechanical stresses. Chemical stresses means the close proximity, if the atmosphere has chemicals, oils or corrosive vapors or dust, will affect the insulation performance, and also it will give aging for the insulating material. When combined with mechanical stresses, gas phase startup and shutdown sequences, expansion and contraction stresses affect the properties of the insulating material. Operation at certain extreme temperature also leads to aging of the materials. In certain areas there will be very cold climates, in certain areas there will be very hot climate. This extreme climate will also give stresses for these electrical insulations. Some environmental contamination means the buildup of mold and particularly deposit in warm, moist environments also contributes to the deterioration of the insulation, insulations of the installation properties. Insulation resistance. In addition to sudden insulation faults due to exceptional events such as flooding, factors liable to reduce insulation performance are combined with the installation is started up, sometimes amplifying one another. In the long term, without monitoring, this will eventually lead to the situation which may be critical in terms of both people's safety and operational consideration. Regular testing of insulation is therefore mandatory for condition monitoring this type of deterioration, so you can act before a complete failure is occurring. Insulation resistance, there are standards we have to obey on this. So certain standards are listed here, ASTM D257. This is a standard test method for DC resistance or conductance of the insulating material. Section 12.1 deals with resistance and conductance. 12.2 volume resistivity and conductivity. 12.3 surface resistance and conductance. IEC 693. This test, this standard deals with volume resistivity and surface resistivity of the solid dielectric material. 60167. This will deal with determination of insulation resistance of the solid insulating material. UL 746A, polymeric materials short-term property evaluation. Section 21, DC resistance or conductance of insulating materials. Principle of insulation testing and influencing factor. Insulation resistance is based on Ohm's law by injecting a known DC voltage for the dielectric material and measuring the current flow. We can find out the resistance value using the Ohm's law, R is equal to V by I. Since the value of insulation is very high, the current flowing will be of very low value or tiny value. So megger is used to indicate the insulation resistance, which is in the order of kilo ohm or mega ohm or giga ohm or also tera ohm. This resistance characterizes the quality of the insulation between the two conductors and gives a good indication of the risk of the leakage current flowing. A number of factors affect the value of insulation resistance and therefore the value of current flowing when a constant voltage is applied for the circuit being tested. These factors such as temperature or humidity, for example, may significantly affect the measurement result. Insulation resistance, so I already stated, it is found out by using the R is equal to V by I. V is the voltage injected, which is a very low DC value, and I is the measured current. Without using separate source for voltage, a separate voltmeter and ammeter, a megger is well enough to measure this insulation resistance. Megger gives a direct DC voltage across the insulator, when the resistive value will range from mega ohm to giga ohm. There are many type of meggers are available, 500 volt megger, 2.4 volt kilowatt megger and 5 kilowatt megger, depending upon the dielectric strength of the material which is going to be tested. For example, 500 volt megger is used for measuring up to 1.1 kV rated insulation for high voltage transformer, other HV equipment and machines. 2.5 or 5 kilowatt megger is used depending upon the insulation level. Insulation resistance. All electric insulators are dielectric in nature. They always have a capacitive property. Due to that, during application of the voltage in the insulator, initially there will be a charging current. After few seconds, this charging current will decay exponentially to zero. Because of that, it is recommended to measure the insulation resistance at least after a minute, some 10 even 15 seconds from the instant of application of the voltage across the insulator. Only measuring insulation resistance by measure may not always give the reliable result, as the resistive nature of the electric insulator may also vary with temperature. This difficulty is partially solved by introducing a concept called polarity index test, or in short PI test. Philosophy lying behind the PI test: when you apply a voltage across this insulator, there will be correspondingly a small current. This small current is contributed by four components, and they are capacitive, conductive, surface leakage and polarization component. Let us first see the capacitive component. Insulator behaves as a capacitor when a DC supply voltage is applied. A high charging current will initially flow, and after that it starts decaying exponentially. The size of the capacitor and the internal resistance of the DC supply, typically few hundred kilo ohms, set the current to zero. In case of generator or motor windings, the current effectively decays to zero in less than 10 seconds. Since the capacitive currents contain little diagnostic information, initial insulation resistance is measured, and once the capacitive current has decayed, hence the first IR measurement has to be made, set 1 minute, to ensure that this current does not have any contribution in the IR calculation. After one second, 10 seconds, then the capacitive current will become zero. If you measure the IR reading, there will be no contribution by this capacitive component. And then comes the conduction current. This current is a conduction current flowing in the dielectric material. As it is high resistive material, this current is of very low value. Every insulator has this component, but in practice, every material in this universe possesses some conductive nature throughout the test. This current may also flow if there are cracks, cuts or pinholes in the ground insulation, and certain contamination will also allow this type of current. This conductive current remains constant and it will not vary with temperature and time. With modern installed insulation, this current is usually zero, as there is no damage in the insulating material. Then comes the surface leakage current. This constant DC current that flows over the surface of the insulation, it is mainly caused by conductive contamination, oil or moisture mixed with dust, dirt, insect, chemicals, etc. on the surface of the windings. This current is also constant with time. The leakage current as well as the conduction current characterize the quality of the insulation and is stable over time. In certain literature, both the current, both conduction surface leakage current, are combined as a single component, and it is called as leakage current component. Next comes the polarization, and this is also known as dielectric absorption current. Every insulator is hygroscopic in nature, since contaminants molecules, mainly like moisture in the insulator, are polar in nature. When an electric field is applied across this insulator, this polar molecule will align themselves in the direction of the application of the electric field. The energy required for this alignment of polar molecule has to be taken from the supply voltage in the form of electric current. This current is called polarization current. It will continue until all the polarized molecules align themselves along the direction of the field. And the time taken will be typically in the order of 5 to 10 minutes. This current falls much more slowly compared to the capacitive charging current. Sometimes it requires several minutes to a value close to zero in the order of 5 to 10 minutes. So if you calculate the total current, it will be due to the sum of the fold currents. IT is equal to IC plus IR plus IL plus IP. Out of this, IC is the capacitive current, IR conductive current, IL leakage current, IP polarization current. So after 1 minute, this capacitive current will become zero. So IT will be IR plus IL plus IP. After 10 minutes, IP will become zero. Then IT will be equal to IR plus IL. So it is a graph showing the different types of current. The green color is the conduction current. See that it is remaining constant throughout the time. It is not varying. If you look into the capacitor, initially it is of high value. After some time, it becomes zero and it is less than 10 seconds. And if there is a peak absorption current which is in pink color, it is also decreasing of nature, but it is taking very long time to reach zero. The total current which is of black color, it is due to the addition of these three currents, green, pink and blue, that is conduction, capacitance and absorption current. Influence of temperature causes the insulation value to vary quasi exponentially. In the context of the maintenance program, the measurement should be carried out in similar temperature condition. As if it is not possible, then the value has to be corrected and it should be exposed to a reference temperature, and after that it has to be compared. For example, as a rough guideline, a 10 degree rise in temperature half the insulation resistance, while the 10 degree reduction in temperature doubles the insulation resistance value. The level of humidity also increases the insulation resistance depending upon the degree of contamination in the insulating surface. Care must be always taken not to measure the insulation resistance if the temperature is below the dew point. It is a graph given the IEEE standard 43-2000, the correction of insulation resistance according to the temperature. K coefficient, which is the correction factor, and your x-axis is the winding temperature. When a Megger value, when insulation resistance value is noted after 1 minute, then the resistance value will be given by supply voltage divided by IR plus IS plus IP. If it measured after 10 minutes, then the resistance value will be V by IR plus IS. So in this, the first value is termed as R1, that is after 1 minute. Next value is R10, which is after 10 minutes. Polarization index is the ratio of Megger value taken for 10 minutes to the Megger value taken for 1 minute. Pi is equal to R 10 minute insulation divided by R 1 minute insulation. So you make use of these two expression and calculate, you get the expression as 1 plus Ip plus Ir plus Is. Here if you see here, the upper component and lower component has the, both will have the temperature roll. Since both have same temperature roll, the temperature effect can be cancelled due to the numerator and denominator, and this term becomes independent of the temperature. From the above equation, Ir plus Is is very much greater than Ip, the polarity index value will approach to 1. That is, the term can be neglected. A large IR or large IS, if both are large, it will indicate the unhealthiness of the insulation, because for a good insulator there should not be any conductive current, and surface leakage current also should be minimum because it is not safety for the operating personnel. The value of PA becomes high if IR plus IS is very small compared to IP. Then there will be high PA value, which implies the healthiness of the insulator. For good insulator, resistive leakage current IR is tiny. It always decide to have the PA of the electric insulator more than 2. It is hazardous to have a PA less than 1.5. So it is the interpretation of the PA result. If a PA value is less than 1, it is hazardous. It has to be thrown out. If the range is between 1 to 1.5, it is bad, going to be replaced. If it is between 1.5 to 2, it is doubtful. If it is 2 to 3, adequate. If it is 3 to 4, good. And if it is above 4, it is excellent. So it is totally categorized into three categories. Less than 2, problem. Some methods has to be implemented. If between 2 to 4, good condition. Greater than 4, excellent. No need for maintenance. If a very high initial IR reading, that is greater than 5 gigaohms, is found, we need not test for PI. That is, you need not worry about the temperature. Importance of PA. PA was developed to make the interpretation of result, which is less sensitive to temperature. PA is the ratio of two IR values measured at two different temperatures, that is 1 minute and after 10 minutes. Temperature of the winding does not rise during the test period of 10 minutes. So it is fairly assumed both R10 and R1 are measured at the same temperature. Then the temperature correction factor will be same for both the cases, R1 and R10, and will be cancelled during the calculation of PA. Thus PA become relatively insensitive to temperature. Further, in the formula of PA, polarization current is used as a yardstick to see if the leakage and conduction currents are excessive. If these latter currents are much larger than the polarization current, ratio will be about 1. It is known from the experience that if PI is about 1, leakage and conduction currents are large enough that electrical tracking will occur. Conversely, if the leakage and conduction current are low compared to polarization currents, PA will be greater than 2, and experience shows that electrical tracking problems are unlikely. Thus, during test, if we see the decay in the total current or rise in the IR in the interval between 1 minute and 10 minutes, then this must be due only due to the polarization current, as the leakage current as well as the conduction current is almost constant due to the entire time, which implies the leakage and conduction currents are low. Next comes the dielectric absorption ratio, DAR. For installation or equipment containing insulating materials in which absorption decreases quickly, insulation measurements after 30 seconds and 60 seconds may be sufficient to qualify the insulation. DAR is defined as, it is a ratio between R 60 second insulation divided by R 30 second insulation. DAR value, if it is less than 1.25, insulation condition is insufficient. If it is less than 1.6, it is okay. It is greater than 1.25 but less than 1.6. If it is greater than 1.6, it is excellent in condition. Next comes the dielectric discharge, DD, or reabsorption test method. This method is also known as reabsorption current method. It is performed by measuring the current during electrical discharge of the equipment being tested. Instead of supplying measuring the value while during supplying the current, it is disconnected from the supply and the value is measured when it is discharging. As all the three components, capacitance, polarization and leakage current, leakage means both conduction and surface leakage, are present during standard insulation test, determination of polarization or absorption may be affected by the presence of leakage current. Instead of trying to measure the polarization current during the insulation test, dielectric discharge DD test measures the depolarization current and the capacity discharge current after the installation test. Measurement principle, equipment which is going to be tested is first charged for long enough to reach a stable state. Capacity charging and polarization is completely completed and only current flowing is the leakage current. Then the equipment is then discharged through a resistor inside a mugger and the current that flow is measured. This current is made only of capacitive discharging current and reabsorption current, which is combined to give total dielectric discharge current. This current is measured after a standard time of 1 minute. The current depends on the overall capacitance and the finite test voltage. Value of DD is calculated using the formula equal to current after 1 minute divided by test voltage into capacitor. So that is I by C. DD test can identify the discharge current occurring when one of the layers of the multi-layer insulation is damaged or contaminated or a defect that may be missed by spot test of PA and DR test. Discharge current will be higher for a given voltage and capacitance if one of the insulation layer is damaged. Time constant of this individual layer will no longer matched with that of the other layers, leading to the higher current value than for undamaged insulation. Homogeneous insulation will have a DD value close to 0, while acceptable multi-layer insulation will have a DD value up to 2. The table below is sanctions according to the DD value obtained. If your DD value is greater than 7, it is bad condition. 4 to 7, once again a poor condition. And 2 to 4, it is questionable, some maintenance has to be taken. Greater than less than 2, it is okay. Caution, this measurement method is temperature dependent, so every attempt should be made to perform the test at standard temperature, at least to know the temperature alongside the test result. You have to note it. So with this you have discussed about the dielectric, different types of dielectric characteristics. If you have any queries, you please comment. So have a nice day. Thank you.